Welcome back to the most news in the morning. 39 minutes past the hour. We're following the latest developments this morning out of Peru, where police are expecting. Tom, first of all, let me just ask you about the situation. How unusual is it that they're actually taking the defendant, the confessed killer in this case, back to the crime scene for reenactment? Paul, if you were defending this young man, would you allow this?
I clearly would not allow it. And as a matter of fact,
in terms of whether or not it's a good move for getting to the bottom of this case, I mean, Tom, as we've seen, this is somebody who reportedly has lied time and time again by his own admission as well, dating back to the 2005 disappearance and presumed murder of Natalie Holloway. So how do they believe what he's saying in this case? Wait, case, Paul, this is moving extremely quickly. We've seen, you know, the videotape released. You saw a video of both of them entering the hotel room, and you saw him leaving the hotel room. And then now you have his confession, which, as Tom said, he could later recant. But meanwhile, as this moves along, what stands out?
Very, very harsh sentencing, and possibly a very, very harsh.
Wait, harsh sentencing? I thought he could only get 15 to 35. They don't have a death penalty.
Well, when I say harsh,
working for them in that they in the Natalie Holloway case, they had no physical evidence. They never found Natalie Holloway. Body, and they also didn't have the benefit of these video cameras that clearly capture Yaron van der Sloot as well as Miss Flores on tape at this hotel.
That's true. They have an entirely different
chip here. I mean, in terms of giving information, in any shape or form.
Well, he does have a bargaining chip. I mean, the Holloway.